This week on Top Billing, Mini Dlamini and Jay Anstey reign supreme in Gert-Johan Coetzee's celebration of the African Queen. Jazz artist Lizz Wright says South African audiences get her music like nowhere else. Two-time Miss Universe winner Catherine Bays weds her Mr. Wonderful, Peter Rademeyer. Josie Trio Musart are the soul of the party scene. SA Cruiserweight champ Kevin the KO Kid Lerena has a new reason to fight. Proteas, Temba, Bavuma and Eddie Leie knock it out of the park on their TV debut. And your presenter, Jonathan Boynton-Lee, brings you the show from a designer showpiece that hasn't forgotten how to be a home.
Good evening and a very warm welcome to Top Billing. Now, in architecture, too much space can get impersonal. What the owners of this home were after was a more intimate family house with a place for everything and everything in its place.
Although Brett and Rose Adams bought a neighboring strip of land for their garden, the area they had to build on was an acute triangular shape. They had to use the plot cleverly to suggest space. So they chose an entrance hall design with a central garden atrium, allowing light and creating breathing room for interior designer Leighton Clapton.
I know who you are.
Yeah, he's the creative genius behind this remarkable home. You know, when we looked at finding somebody to do the interiors and the design and the decorating in this house, the one thing that we said to Leighton is that we wanted it to be simple, yet sophisticated and elegant, and make it a homely environment. We wanted it to be warm for us and for our children, incorporating indoor and outdoor spaces, which I think he's done superbly.
Absolutely. I love how unique this space is. It just flows from one end to the other.
Isn't it amazing?
It is.
I think one of the challenges, Chris, in this particular space was trying to break up the respective spaces, because we have a kitchen, we've got the dining room, it leads out to the formal lounge, and then again to the bar area, as well as out to the garden, the Bavuma area. So all of these respective spaces need to be broken up and segmented within that, but still reading as independently, but keeping that consistency.
I've just touched this seat here and I feel that you've used vinyl. That's a really nice touch.
Because we've got children, we wanted something that was hardy and tough, yet it's still beautiful. And I think he's done a fantastic job.
And easy to clean.
Yeah, definitely.
The bulkheads subtly demarcate each room within the greater living area.
The whole look and feel of the particular home is we've looked at tone on tone, so we haven't had any sort of overpowering colors and kept a very neutral base.
So together with the sophisticated and beautiful furniture that Leighton has spec'd for us, we also wanted to bring some of the peacefulness and tranquility from the garden outside in. And Karin, our landscaper, did a superb job. With the water flowing and the beautiful plants, it's really just created such a wonderful, peaceful environment for us.
The decor suggests a couple who've struck a balance. Their surrounds are luxurious but not showy. And for an exotic influence in their life, they travel.
One of the things, as you'll see, is the there's a lot of high gloss finishes here on there. We've got the dining table, which is a high gloss finish. We've also got a lot of the cabinetry's also got a high gloss finish on it as well. And then we've maintained it with the textured fabric. We've also incorporated a lot more vinyls in the sofas as well, just for the high maintenance and the kids. And we've also put the odd wallpaper in here on there to create a more feature look.
For easy entertaining, steps lead down to a wine cellar and then the bar and Bavuma areas.
One of the important factors of the wine cellar was it actually broke up the space. And not just breaking up the space, I think it's also it's a great focal point, because we've got a glass facade, so you look straight into the wine cellar, so it becomes more of a feature in the home.
What I love is the different levels in the house. That's another unique feature.
It was the lay of the land, and we bring that into different sort of elements, everything from the deck outside leading to the pool, like the ceilings. It segments and breaks those different areas up, but still maintaining that open flow.
The Bavuma really makes this place truly South African.
Yeah, and it's also a very tranquil environment. And we just can't wait as a family to have lovely warm fires going outside with all our friends waiting for the winter.
Am I invited?
If you'd like to come.
We've also used a great outdoor fabric there, so it's completely UV protected and brought a little bit of color into the Bavuma area, and the cushions are an outdoor vinyl.
Natural light is channeled in through the central stairwell, which adds height, and lands in a room where the family spend as much time together as they can.
And here, Chris, we have the pajama lounge. Quite a nice, relaxing family room where the family can just take it easy and really enjoy the space. You'll see we've incorporated a wallpaper in this area as well, but only on one wall. So we haven't wallpapered the whole room, creating a more focal point in this room. And here we've actually custom made the cabinetry to fit within the space. Great for the kids to do homework or for a little study environment.
And it is definitely a well-used space.
The children's bedrooms each have a loft play area. The thought given to creating these spaces is typical of Rose, who gave up her position as a chartered accountant to be a stay-at-home mom. The master suite is certainly worth staying home for.
And here, Chris, you'll see we've incorporated the Vemgi framed headboard with the fabric panels within the headboard and maintaining the tone-on-tone color palette that we've selected throughout the house, but giving it a slightly more feminine approach with the wallpaper, the feathered wallpaper.
And once you close the curtains at night, it really creates such a nice warm environment, like our own little cocoon.
The view from out here is really beautiful, but what caught my eye are those roses. I'm a big softie. I love flowers.
Aren't they spectacular?
Yeah.
Well, I think Karin, our landscaper, is waiting to meet you.
It was a visionary decision to buy this servitude. It allowed a fair-sized lawn, room for the pool not to feel hemmed in, and a decent canvas for Karin Gardelli to work with.
It's no mistake that you have so many roses in here, and our lady of the hour is named Rose.
That's quite correct. She has an absolute passion for roses, as do I. And this is the third garden that I'm doing for them, so I think I do understand what they like. Privacy is very important. So we have created this garden, making a background of very large trees and hoping to block out neighbors and the rose.
Oh, wow, look at this one. This is so beautiful and smells really good.
That is a magnificent rose. That is called Double Delight and is a firm favorite of everybody. It's a magnificent rose. Magnificent.
It absolutely is.
But I must tell you a very poignant story. Brett's mother, who was a great lover of gardens and instilled the love of gardens into her children.
Ingrid, right?
Ingrid, that's right. Brett came to me and asked me whether we could name a rose after Ingrid, which we did. And yesterday we planted the first Nana Ings.
That's
this
the one.
Is the rose. Now Nana is what her grandchildren called her, and Ing is what her husband Keith called her. So this is a very, very special part of the garden, and we have planted 30 of them yesterday for the first time.
Her memory will live on forever.
It absolutely will, and she should be very happy knowing that she's in this peaceful, wonderful, happy garden.
Putt-putt on the roof is a different way for mom and dad to catch up on the day's news, from cricket and tennis-loving Ryan and aspiring dancer Sarah.
What were some of the challenges you faced while building this property, and how did you overcome them?
I wouldn't say challenges. We had a very good team in place, our builder, our architects, Leighton, our interior designer, Karin, our landscaper. So it was actually a pleasure. You know, we've got a finished product, which we're very proud of, and an environment where the kids in this kind of an estate can grow up like we used to grow up. So certainly not a challenge, it's been a pleasure.
Kiddos, what's your favorite part of the house?
My bedroom, because I've got a loft and fairy lights, and I get to play putt-putt outside with my mom, dad, and my sister.
And you, sir?
I love my friends because they bought this beautiful house to have fun and play.
So much of this design is an investment in family, which Brett and Rose realize offers the best dividends of all.
It's got everything that opens and shuts, technology, a magic garden, and plenty of elbow room without feeling like you're living in a showroom. This is a home.
Coming up, every woman's a queen in Gert-Johan Coetzee's couture. And Lizz Wright beats heartbreak with songs of freedom and surrender.
As Gert-Johan Coetzee prepares to launch his latest collection, the Top Billing crew and myself were there to document the action. And as his choice in models suggests, Gert is a man of impeccable taste. Not that I'm even remotely biased.
It's one of the most successful collaborations in SA showbiz. Between Gert and celebrities like actress and TV presenter Minnie Dlamini and model and actress Jay Anstey.
Gert, another range, another milestone, spring summer. What can we look forward to?
This collection is all about eclectic glamour. It's really bringing across every girl's individual queen and femininity in themselves. So it's a lot of African tones. Suede is a big trend for the season, as well as the 70s is just not leaving us. We see it season after season. So what we can expect is a lot of frills, a lot of soft lines, a lot of sheer things. It starts with beautiful solid blacks, going into yellows, going into whites, and then ending off with a strong, powerful blue.
Now we're seeing a lot of really nice earthy African tones and textures, a lot of African influence.
Yes, I'm obsessed with Africa at the moment. I just love where I come from. This season I really wanted to celebrate the African queens and really just celebrate that a Gert-Johan Coetzee girl feels like a queen when she wears the clothes. And that's kind of the aim in every day, what I try and do with the fashion.
SA-born, London-made Aubrey Johnson was behind the lens.
What's happened to your usual dialogue of, hey, sexy, you work good, baby, looking good?
You were in the house, man. I had to keep it tidy.
So it's a respect thing.
Absolutely.
I like it, brother. Look, the pictures are looking beautiful. I'm a little bit biased, but they're looking amazing. What do you think it is about his dresses that photograph so beautifully? There's just something really special about
it. I think it's the textures and the layers that he creates. You know, it's all multi-textured and multi-layered, so just there's a lot of interest in it, interest points. Mm-hmm. So it just reads really nicely when you light it.
While he's not looking, do you mind? You want to jump a couple of shots? Yeah.
Let's do it.
This campaign shows how Gert achieves a consistent and rare class of sensuality across very different female forms.
Ladies, no one understands a woman like Gert. It's not fair.
That's true.
You do, actually, John.
Well, maybe a little bit. I feel like I'm in the jungle here.
Oh, yeah, we're like literally producing our own fruit.
Yeah.
What is so special about Gert's garments? I mean, all the women seem to just love him.
It's just about how he accentuates your features. So even if I'm having a fat day, I know that if I wear a hat, I'll feel unbelievable, I'll feel slim. He just knows what to show and what not to show.
Well, I absolutely love wearing his dresses. I mean, I love showing off my small waist, and he just takes it to a whole nother level. Like, my waist goes from like this size to this size. So I love it, and he understands my shape. And every time I'm on the red carpet or on stage, the comments are always geared to the fact that I look like a dream, and he really celebrates my curves. He just makes such fantastic clothes.
So distinctive, these could be looks in which to have had your portrait painted by artists like Tretyakov or Gustav Klimt. Next up was the catwalk.
Well, this is my friend. You've stolen my date for Fashion Week. So are you going to be my plus one? Because I don't have anyone to go with now.
Unfortunately, I'll be backstage.
Well, you can look after me backstage. Backstage pass, baby.
Look how that happened.
If the collection is inspired by an African queen, then the styling was on trend for the season with a 70s feel.
Now, the great thing about your stuff is for someone like me who doesn't know a lot about fashion, I can still appreciate how you play with textures and color. And I mean, you're even using, this is the material you use for wetsuits.
Yes, that's scuba diving fabric. So you call it neoprene. So when I design a collection, I really try and get something for each individual woman. So if you look through the collection, there should be something that everybody likes, no matter what your taste is. And that is why I try and do, really cater for the South African woman and the African woman.
So all those ladies wearing a dress made out of this at those summer parties, you just jump in the pool, you know, you're going to keep dry the whole night.
Jump in the pool, do a runner. Maybe go and spooky a bit.
Flower detailing added a spring freshness to Gert's trademark sophistication. Frills abounded and maxi dresses wowed.
Sophie, as a gorgeous and powerful woman such as yourself, you must always appreciate what Gert has to show because he really does celebrate women.
Gert has celebrated my body since it was this huge to this huge to this huge. So I definitely celebrate whatever fashion he comes up with on the red carpet. But I think it's not even about the ramp. It's about him understanding a beautiful woman and her body and understanding what she likes and what looks good on her. And I think that's what makes him stand out from a lot of other designers who do spectacular things, but the focus is on the look and feel of the design itself, not on what it will look like on the body, on my body. So he focuses on me.
and the fashion together.
Ladies, we've had a small taste of the collection at the photo shoot, but tonight we really got to see it in all its glory.
It was absolutely fantastic. I just kept sitting there going, I'm wearing that, I'm calling him for that. It was absolutely beautiful. I love the fact that it was ready to wear, so you can really just pick an outfit straight off the runway. I think he did really good, and it's definitely the South African woman shape, and I think it's going to be very successful.
Jay, which dresses am I saving up for?
The last one, babe, sorry.
No, you can't have the last one.
We can share.
How?
I'll wear the top of Well, it's exciting for me, though, because this is the first time since 2013 that I've watched a show. I've walked in every single show, so this is the first year I haven't. So it was amazing for me to be able to actually enjoy the moment, look at all the garments. Also, the list, it's long, John. It's long.
And Claire, it's another massively successful show by Gert-Johan. What is it about the man, do you think, that has stood the test of time in a very difficult fashion industry?
What I enjoy about Gert is the fact that he doesn't mind crossing the boundaries of fashion, and he does it consistently. I mean, his range tonight was absolutely amazing. Apart from the gorgeous models, his outfits made the models look amazing, yeah.
From breast cancer awareness to the importance of water conservation during a global drought, Kat aligns himself with important causes.
Above all, though, the collection is such a beautiful celebration of Africa, of women, and education. It celebrates all those things, so it's fashion with a conscience.
Yeah, I really wanted to this year bring it up to education. Madiba used to say that the strongest weapon any country can have is education. I think the private sector needs to invest in that more. So I have launched a second bursary to go study fashion designing at Northwest School of Design, where I studied. And we have a bursary that's been running for 6 years, so it's so nice to add another bursary. So basically, this is a challenge for the private sector to step in and challenge me and also invest in education.
This is Gert-Johan's third collection in 4 months, and he's already into the 6 months of preparation it will take for his October show.
And lastly, Gert, there's a mystery. Like, the way you understand a woman's body, no one can tell me how you do it. How is it that you understand the woman so perfectly?
I listen to them, Jono. Maybe I must teach you that.
Is it a listening thing?
It's a listening thing.
That's all I had to do all along, was just listen.
Whilst advising Jonathan, Kat has a new bridal collection due and a men's underwear line in the making. He'll rest over Christmas.
If you had to translate how those women look into music, it might sound like the earthy, irresistible jazz of our next guest, Lizz Wright. Her voice is a natural wonder of the world, and Nico got to spend the whole day listening to it. Somewhere down the stairs,
another car. Lizz Wright has overcome a car accident and disappointment in love with her triumphant new album, Freedom and Surrender.
Well, Lizz, welcome to South Africa. I should say welcome back, because you've been here before, right?
I have, Nico. Thank you. I was here 3 or 4 years ago at the Joy of Jazz Festival in Johannesburg.
Well, you're back here again, this time for another jazz festival. Are you excited?
I am. I remember being struck by the way the South African people listen to music. They catch all kinds of subtle nuances that everyone else misses, and it doesn't matter how large the crowd is, like they listen in this really particular way that's a marvel to me.
Well, I brought you to one of the most beautiful gardens in South Africa. I thought it would make you feel at home, because that's where you live in North Carolina, close to the mountains and close to nature.
I do. This is the way I prefer to live, you know. I feel like observing nature is where I get a lot of inspiration from, a lot of clarity from.
And apparently you love gardening as well, and you cook.
I love to go to the farmers markets on Saturday mornings and gather whatever they have that's just radiating, even if it's handmade pasta, you know, and I just try to figure out what to make. And sometimes I'll go over to the house of a friend and just prepare a big spread of food and call everybody over.
Well, today I'm not going to make you work for your food. I've got a delicious surprise for you at one of the best restaurants in the Cape. I hope you're hungry.
After the meticulous studio recording with 4-time Grammy-winning producer Larry Klein, Lizz seemed to be loving the freedom of our lunchtime band. Her songwriting recipe is knowing just how much personal experience to share. Not too bitter, not too sweet.
Okay, ooh, look at that. Winnie, what do we have here?
So that's the bread platter. Tunisian bread, Moroccan bread, chickpea dip, and Juka olive oil. And that's our famous house salad, cheese and onion samosas, and that's African spinach, 3 bean curry, and the oxtail hummus.
Nice. See, I told you. Your father was a church minister and you led the choir. I would imagine that had quite the influence on your musical beginnings.
Definitely. Growing up in a small church like that was like probably growing up on a small farm. You know, everybody had a job. And my aim was to do music, so I had to learn how to put together music for different parts of the service to make people feel certain ways at certain times. So it was my first bit of practice at making a set list.
You obviously love creating your own music and you're so good at it, but you don't shy away from celebrating other masterpieces.
I think that's important. As a songwriter, you know, it's my only way to really study music and study the craft is to cover great music. My heart, my mind, my soul, my feelings. It's my absolute pleasure to do, you know, Neil Young, Led Zeppelin, any of that. You know, it's just, it's beautiful work and I want to know what made it work, what made it speak to so many people, you know? And with a childhood when my father read all kinds of stories to me, he read, you know, Shakespeare's plays, Uncle Remus stories, I kind of see songs as stories. So in this tradition of storytelling, I just pick up something because it's beautiful, you know, and because it's interesting, and I want to know it.
Well, since you draw your inspiration from nature and your surrounds, if you had to dedicate one song off your album to this lovely place, to Kirstenbosch, and to, I'm trying to get you to dedicate a song to Top Billing, which one would it be?
You know, maybe Somewhere Down the Mystic. It has some impressions of mountain life, you know, like the blue light bugs, we call them fireflies. And, you know, I have a big wood-burning stove, and there's a reference to that. But I wanted to give the fans, like, some impressions of what my life has been like now that I've moved. I left Brooklyn, New York, and I moved back out to the country, you know.
Ah, I know which one you're talking about. I've forgotten how it goes. Will you remind me?
Somewhere down the mystic, another kind of angel calls, another kind of glory, another kind of fall. It's kind of a weird chord. You have to hear the whole song to know why I sang those crazy notes, but.
Bergwater.
Being told you have a voice like water from the mountain is unusual, and Lizz loved it.
Nico is right. The sound of Bergwater absolutely captures her sound. If you're a Lizz Wright fan, let us know how you would describe that extraordinary voice.
Up next, two-time Miss Universe Kat Bass weds her Mr. Wonderful. And from Say Yeah to Party After, MuseArt have us feeling good.
I love this week's marriage proposal story. When Peter Rademacher decided to make things official with two-time Universe fitness champion Catherine Bass, he saw a unique window of opportunity and grabbed it.
4 years before her wedding day, Kat was getting a relaxing sports massage when through the headrest, she saw Peter Rademacher's hand holding a ring. She said yes, and now Miss Universe was about to become Mrs. Rademacher.
The dress, we've got to talk about this dress.
I designed it myself, the basics of it, but an Alberta took over. It's got a lot of detailing, as you can see, so it's a very Egyptian, Grecian styled dress. We have pearls, we've got lace, we have netting, very rich, warm colors. We've got the gold diamantes, we have some gold lace, and of course the shoulder caps were my favorite part of the dress. And not to forget the back of the dress, also with the chains, and mermaid style is the shape that we went for.
Well, you are the epitome of a beautiful bride. I'll see you down the aisle.
Kat's theme was Greek-Roman. For a woman with three world fitness titles and preparing for her fourth, she's been very hands-on with preparations at the Avianto wedding venue.
It was for her very important that actually must be exactly what she dreamed about. And it's so nice when somebody like a Kat walk in, so vibrant, so energetic, and so ready for this. And it helps us as flower people and decor people to just get part of that vibe, part of that energy, and put it into the wedding and help to create a stunning, beautiful day.
The cake would be a cheat meal the couple allow themselves to feed their souls. That aside, they and their much-loved dog Spike lead a healthy lifestyle, as Peter's son and best man Sean has come to know.
I've just seen your bride before you did, and I've got to say, you are one lucky man.
Yeah, I am. She's truly beautiful, isn't she?
Absolutely.
Yeah, God's blessed her, so, yeah.
Even Spike's looking good. Hey, Spikey. Behind that tough exterior, I know there's a soft heart. Are you nervous at all?
I'm very calm about it. I think it's not so much of a man's day today, I think, but more of a lady's day. I'm honored and privileged that she's my wife, and I left the rest of the day to her.
The two of them, they complement each other. Their achievements speak for themselves for the last couple of years, what they have achieved together. Yeah, I'm looking forward to being the best man at the wedding, and I mean, it's my father and Kat's stunning couple.
Maid of honor, Nikita Valentine, is Kat's best friend, and guests were from their very close circle.
You know, Pete's a good mate of mine. Watching his reaction as he saw his bride coming down the stairs, he was like giggling and bouncing around like a little kid again. It was, you know, that's awesome to see something like that happen. I mean, she obviously brings out an emotion in him that only she can, and it's an inspiration to all of us, and God bless him, and let's see them live happily ever after, eh?
It was absolutely beautiful. The way Pete looked at Kat coming down was magical, and little Spike just brought a little extra excitement to the ceremony. It was awesome.
Kat and Pete are very similar in a lot of ways. What makes them a perfect match?
Apart from them both being the fitness industry, originally Pete was the one that pulled Kat into this, and he supported her all the way. I think he's her biggest fan. And you know, the way they treat people with respect, for me as a couple, that's very important.
What I really like about Catherine and Pete is the way they communicate with each other. It's something I've observed from when they started dating like 7 years ago, and I just loved how they handled each other. Whether it's a good day or bad day, they knew how much love to give, and I've learned so much from observing them as a couple, and I really cherish it about them.
After the couple's 8 years together, Kat and Peter's children are good friends.
This is a setting fit for a king and queen. The lighting, the design, the decor, everything really complements the king and the queen themselves, Kat and Pete. What do you think about it?
Yeah, absolutely amazing. You know, my dad has always been my king. He is an amazing man, and she is a queen. She really is. Her persona, everything about her, the whole place is just absolutely amazing. The decor, everything about it is just so beautiful.
They met when she was a service advisor at a car dealership. He texted her. She was involved, but 2 years later, she got back to him. They had lunch, and that was it.
Ladies, heartfelt speeches, a really lovely couple.
It was absolutely amazing. I mean, to hear those speeches, like, I absolutely felt the love that these two share. And I hope that one day my significant other can speak of me in the same breath. It was absolutely amazing to hear their story and how they met. Was absolutely breathtaking. I hope I have that one day as well. It was amazing.
He's my brother-in-law. Of course, I love him to bits, and Kat's now my sister-in-law. I adore them. They're the most amazing couple, and I think they're going to be very happy together.
Kat and Peter now head for the US and hopefully another title, and then their honeymoon.
Take us through some of the special moments. What stood out for you today?
Chris, I think, first of all, my beautiful wife. She's beyond words for me. I think you asked the question, what more could have been a perfect day? Nothing more. To have a wife like I have, I'm truly blessed.
So what's next for Mrs. and Mr. Rademeyer?
Kat?
The next big thing on our agenda would be defending my Universe title in Miami. Definitely have to go claim that back. I think that's our next goal.
You're a true testament to a couple who trains together, stays together.
The proof is in the pudding, Chris.
Enough said.
How were the guns on those women? Everyone at that wedding was packing. Now onto a marriage of a different kind, between art and music, as we profile Sama-nominated soul trio, Mozart. To the left and we say yeah, yeah,
yeah, yeah. 6 years ago, musicians Tazile Hutso and Victory Chauke met and approached TV presenter Rorisang Tanegiso to be the ambassador for their musical production team. Then she stepped behind the mic and a world of possibility opened.
So the love of music has kept you guys together for quite a while, and you've exploded onto the scene because I can believe that that's what passion does.
Yeah. that's what we're all about, music and art, but I think the music has really just launched us out. I mean, 2015 was an amazing year for us, oh yeah, which was actually probably the least song we preferred on the album. The same song got 2 sync deals, which is amazing for any artist. But it really just, it spread us out to different radio stations, different parts of South Africa. So yeah, man, so that song has basically moved from being the least favorite to probably being one of our favorite songs now.
The band are as visual as they are musical, hence Muzart. Their sound is a layer cake of jazz, pop, house, gospel, and soul, with even classical genius Mozart as inspiration.
With all that influence, you have the musical talent to back it up. You're also multi-instrumentalists.
I grew up in church. I'm a pastor's kid. So, you know, like every pastor's kid has to sing or either play drums, keyboards. They have to do something in the church. So that's basically where I learned my skills, man. So most of the synth stuff in the album, which is like, you know, those leads, da, ba, da, ba, it's me. So I play keys.
I also play keys, but I play like your pianos, your Rhodes, stuff that people don't take notice of, but have other bed in the song.
Right.
Yeah, so it also put some bass on there. Yeah, that's me.
So these guys are being so modest right now, to tell you the truth. They both play keys, both play bass really, really well. But I play the most important instrument, which is the vocal cord. But that kind of sucks, because you guys also, yeah, man, they took my shine.
I've also got a little trick up my sleeve. I can beatbox. Check it out.
Ayo, we're hanging out, chilling out right here. About to get some meat, so I'm really, really hungry. Yo, we're chilling out. About to hang out right here. I thought I was
going to
sing, but it sounded so rappy.
Nice, nice, nice. You've got the talent, you've got the passion. Where did all the inspiration start?
We're inspired by some amazing artists. We're inspired by our environment. I mean, our everyday life. If you listen to our music, we speak about being happy. We speak about the different things that we see in our spaces, you know, whether it's the urban vibes where we grew up, the experiences that we've come across. And then there's just like some really, really legendary dope people that we look at and we're like, yeah, I want to be like that guy. Like Mozart is one of them. Like, you know, at such a young age, he stepped out to be a composer, composing classics, which is, I think, what we want.
After enjoying a big meal, I've discovered that Muzart's music gets interpreted differently. But what stands out for me is the funk. Hence, me bringing him back to a skating rink so that we can get back onto the soul train. What's happening, guys? Who's got the funk?
Chris got the funk.
I think you're doing good. Party After is a perfect song to come and do this to, right?
Yeah. Totally.
What inspires you guys' music?
I think what keeps us going is really people's reactions. Is when we make music for ourselves firstly. Things that we enjoy, that we love doing, and love performing. So when we get a reaction from people, it's like, they really are vibing with us. I think that in itself inspires us to get back into studio. I'm out of breath. This is a workout, y'all. <job. laughs> That inspires us to get back into studio and continue giving them the music that they clearly are loving.
I know you guys are quite busy, so where to from here?
We're working on our second album. We're gonna give you more the funk. Actually, it's called Facets. So this is a new side to Muzart. That's the road ahead for Muzart.
Yeah. A lot of artists do well in studio, but you guys thrive on stage.
As any musician, we like to perform, you know? I think that's where people can emotionally connect with us, apart from the radio stuff.
I mean, we shared stage with your Bunga Muffins, your people from China, from all over the world. We've really been blessed when it comes to live performances and getting an experience to perform with people from different genres, I think has been our biggest blessing.
Guys, lunch was on me. Last one around the track, buy supper. DJ, drop the beat. Whoop. There we go. Whoop. Who's got the fun? Gotta have that fun. The party after.
Fresh from their set at the Cape Town International Jazz Festival, their new single and video, Don't Take Your Love, is dropping soon.
Chris, Simba would be very proud that Top Billing has its own beatboxer on the show again. Then he'd tell you he's much better.
Next up, he's SA Cruiserweight Champion, and with a new family to fight for, Kevin the KO Kid Lerena looks unstoppable.
With statistics, it's all relative. SA Cruiserweight Champion Kevin Lerena has 14 wins, but what you need to know is that 10 of those were by knockout. There's a reason he was invited to train with Floyd Mayweather, and that's because Kevin is the real deal.
It's hard to believe anyone could have once bullied this 90-kilogram WBC Youth World and SA Champion. But he was a smaller guy at school, and taking up boxing evened the odds. He turned pro at 18 and hasn't looked back.
Boxing is definitely not for the faint-hearted. It takes a very special kind of athlete to do this for a living. It takes incredible discipline. I learned this the hard way with my brief stint as a boxer, as you'll maybe remember. But I'm back with a vengeance, baby. And I'm here today to learn from one of the best. Kevin the KO Kid Lerena.
Hey, time out, dude. You're looking sharp there, my brother.
Thank you, brother.
Hey? Still a young career, but you've already got 10 knockouts, just 14 fights. That's an incredible knockout percentage, my man.
Thank you. Now look, we take it step by step. Big aspirations, big goals. Got my family to keep happy, so boxing pays the bills.
You're up at 4:30 a.m. every single day. It takes a lot of discipline to get to where you are, to be a champ.
100%, Johnny, you know, it's all about hard work. You got to put in the hours, you know, 3 sessions a day. If you're pushing an hour session, that's good. Sometimes you got to go 2 hours. You got to put your miles in on the road. When your trainer says you're sparring 8 rounds, you got to tell him you want to spar 10. You got to keep improving and not forgetting about your strength sessions. Keep your speed and power up. You know, if you want to be a champion, you got to push 3 sessions a day, otherwise you're wasting your time.
Kevin achieved 3 distinctions in matric and often visits schools giving motivational talks on what boxing has taught him.
So when you're throwing your right, if you bring your right through, you bring it with your hips. There, your power is generated through your foot. Hands up, and when you hit the 1-2, the right comes through, you generate your power through your hips. Turn your hips, can't hit your chin. You see that? Chin's down, protected by your shoulder. Throw a 1-2, keep your chin down. Turn your hips more. There we go, chin down, much better. There we go, turn your hips, much better. That's power, more power.
Okay, I'm putting everything behind these punches, and as you can see, this bag is hardly buckling. If you want to see why this guy's called the KO Kid, give us that straight left of yours at your lethal weapon. Check this out. Okay, that's power. I want to see that action in the ring, my man.
Let's go.
I'm going to make this bag buckle now. There we go.
Sean Smith is Kevin's trainer. The son of an SA champion, Sean was an unbeaten amateur until injury ended his career.
Sean, you've been with Kevin right from the start. What makes this kid so special?
The day that he lays it up, I like knew that he'd be able to make it in this sport of boxing. He's just a good all-round athlete, and he's a winner. Whatever he seems to do, he just seems to excel in. He's a super talent, super kid, and just an all-round awesome gent.
Kev, the way you're hitting those pads, this is the only way I'm going to ever be in the ring with you. I can tell you that much. I want to know what's going through your mind from the moment you walk out there, your song's playing, as you're approaching the ring, when you're in the ring, you're taking hits. Take us through what's going through your mind.
The moment you walk into the ring, it's all mental warfare. You know what you've prepared for, you've got your opponent standing in front of you, and he's the only man standing in between you and what you want to do, your dreams, your success. So the job is to get the job done, and that's beating. That's all that goes through my mind, is winning.
Okay, now the big question is, are you ready to go a couple of rounds with the John Meister over here?
No, brother, I'm always looking for work.
On the bag, John had felt the champ's power. Most surprising is how quickly he strikes.
You knocked my contact out, dude.
Okay, contact's out. I can't see anymore, Kev. I can't see, that's my excuse.
Let's go to the racetrack.
Gotta go to the racetrack now.
Outside the ring, Kevin is a gentle, caring guy. Jay Anstia joined Gina to take on the guys at karting.
It's okay.
Now Kevin punched me.
Kevin, why are you my man? Do you want to fight with me?
Challenge me.
You don't want to take on this woman, trust me.
Do you know, we've seen Kevin in the ring, it gets really intense. I don't even know how you watch.
Yeah, it's extremely intense. I often think I shouldn't go and, you know, should just stay and hide. But, you know, it's good for support and, you know, he's going to do what he's got to do.
What about the build-up to fight week? Things must get really intense at home.
Yeah, our fight week is very hectic. If Kevin has to cut weight, there's a lot of fish, a lot of broccoli. Just make sure everything's prepared for him. He gets very moody.
I'm ratty because I'm cutting weight and it can't be easy, but I commend her because she's just a good lady. She's a good wife and it's all worth it afterwards, but leading up to it's hard.
Wrap him in cotton all week, basically.
You're taking some notes there.
You're making me look bad.
I think let's sort this age-old debate out on the track, because girls always think they're better drivers. She thinks she's a better driver.
I am.
At all.
I am.
So, guys versus girls, what do you think?
Done. Let's do it.
We can
you
do
better
it.
Pull it through. Let's
go. Judging by his speed in the ring, this round would go to Kevin too.
You'll notice when I was in the ring, I didn't use any head protection with Kevin, because I'm hardcore like that, and I'm the same when it comes to the racetrack, because I'm sexy like this. And when I feel sexy, I drive sexy.
In Kevin's last title fight, he came out firing from the start. As a First Team Cares rugby player who was then offered a contract with the Golden Lions, the champ broke defenses with his skill more than his brawn, and it showed on the track. Jono accepted second place. At least he'd beaten the girls.
Well done, champ. Champion of the ring, champion of the racetrack. Ladies, where were you guys? You were holding us up there.
Oh, well, sorry.
Next time.
Made me win.
Today, Kevin's happy, relaxed place is at home or out walking with Gina and his four-month-old son, Brooklyn.
Kev, this is what it's all about. This is why you do what you do.
I know, it's been amazing having him come into our life just about 4 weeks before my last fight. Was a big challenge, but you know, it makes you more hungry every time you go out there and fight. I do it for him, I do it for Gina. So the whole dynamics have changed, you know, the responsibilities, the routine, but you know, it's all worth it in the end.
You know, we had a newborn baby and obviously it wasn't easy, but we both pulled through, made it work, and you know, he did extremely well. I think I'm definitely Kevin's biggest supporter. Win or lose, I'm there no matter what, and love him no matter what, whether it's boxing or whatever it is.
You had the amazing opportunity of being able to train with Floyd Mayweather himself.
I get goosebumps when I talk about him. That is one phenomenal athlete. It was an all-around great experience, you know. I had the chance to watch him prepare for the biggest fight of the century, Manny Pacquiao, and spar in front of him and get a little bit of advice from him and just to rub shoulders and talk to him, you know. He's worked really hard to give his kids a better life, and that's what I want to do.
What advice have you got for all those youngsters that want to follow in your footsteps?
Definitely the first one is never stop dreaming. I believe the sky is the limit, and set those goals and targets, because no matter where you are in life, you can always be better, and that's one of the mottos that I live by.
If you're knocked down, you get up again. Little Brooklyn has taken notes.
It takes a brave man to go up against Kevin, for real. And when you hear that he fights for his family every time he steps into that ring, all I can say to his opponents is good luck to you.
Still to come, Proteas, Temba, Bavuma and Eddie Leie become soap stars. Then enter tonight's top billing competition in association with Standard Bank.
Fusion. It works in jazz music or Asian Pacific cooking. But can a cricketer walk off the pitch onto the set of Isidingo and deliver a compelling performance? Eddie Leie and Temba Bavuma were up for the challenge.
The Proteas' first black Test Centurion and their new T20 Spinwiz weren't scared of a touch of bass.
Gents, you're both looking really good. I must say that I'd never seen cricketers with makeup before. How does it feel?
Yeah, for me, it's a bit different. You know, I don't know what Eddie, my friend here, thinks, you know, having makeup and all. You know, like you said, you know, we're used to being on the field, you know, running around, you know, sweating.
Yeah, you know, I'm a dark-skinned person and I became a bit yellow from the makeup and stuff. I saw a different me there.
The guys were doing this as part of celebrating all that's right about SA cricket. And the Isidingo team are proudly South African.
You've had many cameos on the set of Isidingo. How do you think they'll fare?
I've got a good feeling about them. I think they're actually going to nail it. Huh?
So, I mean, we've had a lot of sporting personalities on the show, but I think they'll be just as good as anyone else we've had on before.
They seem like naturals.
Yeah. Yeah, on the pitch and on set.
Seasoned acting pros Jack Devnarain, a former powerlifter, and Isak Davel, a keen cyclist and swimmer, were impressed at how their guest stars fared on camera.
Acting alongside some of the country's greatest cricketers, how do you think they fared?
How did we fare?
I don't know who was more nervous.
See, I think the main thing is that we had fun and that it was relaxing, and I want their experience to be you are in the company of professionals, this is our space, we're going to take care of you, and you have the space to have fun. Which I imagine, if it were turned around and we ended up, you know, in a pitch somewhere...
We'd have fun.
Well, it's possible.
They'll take them a while to bowl us out, I reckon.
I could take all day.
Talking about acting tips and cricket tips, I'm sure they could give you some cricketing tips. What sort of acting tips do you think you could give them?
I think it was more about having fun with the script and saying, all right, here's the text. We've got to take the text and our great help, Athos, put together something really clever and creative, and we could bring that to life. And I think that's the trick for somebody coming into it for the first time. How do I take the writing and bring it to life and make it easy to listen to?
Your guys definitely know their cricket. And, you know, in a way, their passion for the game is quite inspiring.
It's actually humbling to see that the whole country's behind us.
Oh, every Friday is Protea Fire Friday.
Whether spreading the fire of enthusiasm about SA cricket or as a TV acting debut, they had knocked it out of the park.
Guys, that was absolutely fantastic. I must say that your family is going to be so, so proud.
Yeah, I think my family will be proud, you know, being not only watching us on the cricket field, now seeing us on their favorite soapy. I'm actually excited what they're about to say, really, what they're going to say about it. Definitely was a good experience.
Guys, can you pull any similarities between working on the cricket field and show business?
Yeah, definitely. You know, at the end of the day, you know, all of us be performing. You know, us as cricketers, you know, we have to go, you know, in front of a big capacity crowd and do what you get paid to do. Same with, you know, with Jack and Isra and all the other actors. They also got to perform, you know, and they also have to have that temperament to be able to do that day in and day out.
I have no idea what she is.
So I've given you some acting tips. Are there any cricketing tips that you can give me?
I mean, for us, cricket was always a passion, you know, growing up from a young age. And, you know, if you have a passion, just follow it.
Nothing beats hard work, you know. I think it's everything in life as well. You know, you have to work hard in whatever you want to achieve. And if your heart is in it, then you work hard in it, you might achieve what you want to achieve.
From their lips to the ears of tomorrow's cricketing greats.
Are you a cricketer who's one acting class away from a career in soapies? Are you an actor who, with a little coaching, could play for the Proteas? Then tonight's top billing competition prize in association with Standard Bank might come in handy.
To stand a chance of winning 2,000 Rand with Top Billing and Standard Bank to move your dreams forward, tell us which instant messaging platform provides Standard Bank customers with 24/7 banking. Is it 1. WeChat or 2. WeTalk? Simply SMS the keyword forward followed by your answer 1 or 2 and your name to 33727. That's 33727. SMSs are charged at 1 rand. T's and C's apply and can be found at topbilling.com. Competition closes midnight on Wednesday, the 27th of April. Standard Bank, moving you forward.
After tonight's show, I'm reminded of all the reasons I love the beautiful, talented, crazy, inspired, and brave people of this country. Until next week, good night, and God bless you, South Africa.